In this video, I explained the spray formation inside the engines. Now, we all know that, or we all use the body spray, room air fresheners. Okay, so just we understand this phenomena of the spray we use. Okay, so suppose we spray the body spray on our body. Okay, so we know that we maintain a certain distance between the bottle and our body. Okay, so it's called as the penetration. Suppose this is here the bottle and here our body. Okay, so it may be different ways possible. Either the spray does not come to our body, or the spray come on the less area of the body and larger area of the body. Okay, so when the distance between our body and the spray bottle is too larger, then it is possibility is that the spray does not come in contact with our body. Okay, that means the penetration length is larger, because the spray is not able to come to the our body. Means distance between the bottle and the our body, it's called as the penetrations. Okay, and what amount of the area the spray come into contact with the our body, it is depend on this cone angle. Okay, so this is called as the cone angles. Now then, after we reduce certain length between the body and the spray, okay, then what happen? Some area of the our body comes in contact with the spray. When we more take near the spray bottles, then what happen? The spray is cover more body area. Okay, so this is called generally on the two phenomena. One is the penetrations, and another on the distributions, or it is known as the cone angles. Okay, so similarly, this phenomena is applicable inside the engines, but in engines proper atomization is also required. When in the spray bottle we see that it is in the liquid forms, when this spray come in the out from the body, it is come in like as the vapor or a small droplet forms. Okay, so similar things is happen inside the engines that we understand in this detail. So when the fuel is forced through the nozzle hole under a high pressure, it is disintegrated into a fine droplets. Okay, so this is similarly happen in the spray bottles. Due to the aerodynamic resistance of the dense air present in a combustion chambers. So we know that in a combustion chambers, at the end of the compressions, the pressure of the compressed air is high, or a compression ratio is near to 14 to 22. Okay, so we require to spray the diesels than the higher pressure than the compressed air present inside that. Suppose compressed air pressure is 25, then we require to spray the fuel at a 70 bar or a 80 bar pressures. Okay, so more pressure than it is properly penetrated inside this combustion chamber lens. So in our terms, what is the length of penetrations? So it is the distance between the cylinder head and the TDC. So when the way spray the diesels and it is reach up to the TDC, then it is called as the proper penetrations. And distribution means it is go in every part of the combustion chambers, then it is called as the distributions. The combustion chamber pressure at the time of injection is about 25 to 35 bars, and density is 12 to 14 times that of the ambient air. The various phase of the spray formations at the fuel injected through the nozzles are shown in these figures. So in this image, you see the various part, image A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, so this every image we understands in the details. So first, when the diesel is coming out from this, fuel is coming out from the nozzles, so you see this is a small droplets, then after it is converted. So we study this different phase and what are the parameter that affect to the proper distributions and penetrations of the spray. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons, or you also visit the playlist for watching the more video related to IC engines and the mechanicals engineering. The link is also provided in top right screens of your mobiles or a laptop from the I symbols. So here we use this figure again. At the start of the fuel injection, the pressure difference across the orifice is low. Okay, so we know that, or you already study in a valve timing diagram, that the diesel spray is start 30 to 40 degree before the TDC. Okay, and it's completed after the TDC. So it is spray for a certain angles. So when the spray or the diesel spray start or a fuel spray start, they have a certain pressures. Okay, so orifice is one part of the injectors. Okay, so on a one side of the orifice, that is the combustion chambers, means that is the compressed air is available, and on the another side of the orifice, inside the fuel injectors, that is the diesel pressure is there. Okay, so this pressure is, pressure difference is low at the starting of the fuel injections. Therefore, the single droplets are formed as shown in this figure A. Okay, so at the starting of the injection, this type of the droplets are come. Okay, as the pressure difference increase, the flow following process occurs one after one. Why this pressure difference is increase? Okay, so diesels are coming with more pressures, or the pressure inside the engine is increased, because when the combustion is start, the pressure is suddenly increased. Then after the expansion is start, then the pressure is start to reduce. The pressure difference is continuously changes. Okay, and it is gradually increasing. First, a stream of fuel emerge from the nozzles as shown in this figure B. Okay, so when the slight pressure difference is increase, then the droplet shapes are changed. It start to get in the longer shapes. The stream encounters aerodynamic resistance from the dense air pressure in the combustion chambers, 12 to 14 degree times in ambient pressures, and break into a spray. Why this shape is coming? It's come due to the aerodynamic resistance. Means the compressed air create the resistance to these droplets of the fuels. Okay, so that's called as the aerodynamic resistance. Say at the distance of L3 as shown in this figure C, means this droplet length is achieved from this L1 to L3. Then after it start to break up at the certain distance, means from the L2 distance it start to break up. Means from the one droplets, number of droplets is created. Okay, that is called as the breakup. The distance of this point where this event occur from the orifice is called as the breakup distance. Means from the orifice, suppose this droplet is break here, then after another droplet is come. Otherwise this breakup is not process continuous, then what happen? That continuous stream is coming out from the orifice. But the continuous droplets are not coming, it's the break. So the distance of this point where the this event is occur, means breaking off is occurs from the orifice, is called as the breakup distance. Means one flame is created, one droplet is created up to L3 lengths. Then after it is break up from here, and the another droplet is start. Okay, this is called as the breakup distance. As the pressure difference across the orifice further and further increase, in the breakup distance is decrease. Means pressure difference is increase, then the breakup distance is decrease, and the cone angle is increase until the apex of the cone is particularly coincides with the orifice. That is a figure D, E, N, F. Okay, so when the pressure difference across the orifice is increased, then the breakup distance is decreased. Means breakup is start at the smaller distance, and you see that in E image the cone angle is increased. In certain image, that is a C and D, you see this cone angle is lower, but in a figure E this cone angle is larger. In a F further cone angle is increased. So this is a continuous process. First the droplets very small, then after is length is increased, then the breakup is coming out, and after breakup the cone angle is start to increase. So these are the various phases of the spray formations. All these successive phase of the spray formation occur in a very short times. So we know that the engine is running at the very high speed. Okay, so that is the number of time the spray is supplied. Suppose that is a 4-stroke diesel engine running at the 4000 RPMs. Okay, means 2000 times the diesel is spray in a 1 minute. So this process is very quick. Now next we understand what are the parameters that affect to the spray formations. Means one is the size of the large droplets. Okay, that is the size of the droplets is larger, then what happen? So large droplet have the capacity to high penetrations compared to the small droplets. Means the droplet size is larger, then what's the possibility? It penetrate higher. But from the point of view of quick mixings and evaporations, means the liquid is start to vaporize form, it is called as the evaporations, and evaporation is faster than mixing is proper. If evaporation is slow, then mixing is not proper. So from the point of view of quick mixings and evaporation of dual smaller droplets are required. Means for a mixing and the better evaporations, smaller droplets are required. And for a point of view of the higher penetration, larger droplets are required. Means larger droplet give proper penetrations, but they are not give the proper evaporations and the proper mixings. It is mean droplet diameters which indicate the quality of atomizations. Okay. Means there is a small droplet size, then proper atomization is there. Larger size droplet, then proper atomization is not there. So smaller the diameter is the proper the atomizations. The usual size of the droplets is less than the 5 microns. It is worth to mention that droplet size is governed by the injection pressures. So one factor is apply the injection pressure, second factor is the diameter of the orifice, third factor is the fuel viscosity, and the fourth is the air density as given below. Okay. So we understand if the pressure is increased, diameter is increased, then what happens? So as the injection pressure is increased, the droplet size is increased. Okay, so we require the higher pressure for a small droplets, because according to the smaller droplet size, we achieve the quick mixing and proper evaporations. Second it, with increasing air density in a combustion chamber, mean droplet size increase. Means after the combustion compressions, the air density is the higher than the smaller droplet size is achieved. As the size of orifice increase, the mean droplet size is increased, and droplet size is increased than the not proper evaporation, but the larger penetration is achieved. Higher fuel viscosity, larger is the droplet size. Okay, so viscosity of the fuel is higher than the droplet size is the largest. The penetrations of the spray depends on the momentum of the droplets. So it is not only depend on the size of the droplets. Okay, so penetration is depend on the momentum of the droplets and the density of the air in the combustion chambers. Higher the momentum, greater is the penetrations of the spray. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and don't forget to share with your friends and comment on the video.